So, good morning, everyone, and welcome to our Sunday sitting, Sunday morning here in California, and good afternoon to those of you in afternoon places, and good evening, and good night to those getting ready for sleep. So here we are, and I'm very happy to share this sitting with you. And, you know, it goes without saying that these are extraordinary times. And I hope that the period of meditation is the appropriate way of being available for the world, for others, for ourselves at this time. One of the principles of So I hear some one of the principles of mindfulness meditation is that it really helps for it to be simple. There's a saying that if it's not simple, it's not mindfulness. And that to not be very ambitious, but to be simple with oneself, with how one is. To make a little bit of space to allow ourselves to be how we are, to recognize how that is, to relax about how it is, to maybe unwind or let go or settle in, to open up in some deeper way, so that at the end of the meditation, perhaps we're a little bit more available to the world, or available to the circumstances we're in, available in a useful way, in a wise way. In these days, a lot of being available for many people is being available to the uncertainties and the changes from day to day. And being available doesn't necessarily mean we know what to do, but we are available. So to begin this meditation, to begin as simple as possible, perhaps closing your eyes and checking in with yourself. How are you? How is it to be present in your body? How is your body? Check in with your mind and your thoughts. And what are your concerns? What's up for you that is going on? And to check in with your heart. How are you feeling? What emotions are present? And to check in with yourself, and to see if you can be simple with how it is. Simple perhaps without the complexities of judging it, of feeling something needs to be fixed, or trying to change it, but rather to be simple and make space for how you are. To allow how you are to exist in a friendly field of awareness. So meditation is not getting away from how you are, but it's really a more caring way of checking in and being with how you are. and then to support the movement towards simplicity, to perhaps take a few long, slow, deep breaths. As you exhale, settling in, not so much to change anything, but exhaling so you can center yourself on yourself. Center yourself in the middle, at the center of your being. Every exhale, a return to some center within. And every exhale, an expansion of breathing and also of awareness. It makes room for how you are. Everything can be held in awareness. Letting your breathing return to normal. And perhaps there's ways you can soften your body, relax into yourself. Sometimes the tensions we hold in our body are a pulling away from something, from ourselves or from the world. And this soften and relax the body. So it's the opposite of pulling away. It's a relaxing into yourself and a relaxing into the world. Perhaps it's possible to soften the tensions or the pressure to think. I like the image of a wide, peaceful, quiet surface of a lake. To allow your thinking mind, the waves of thinking, settle and quiet so that your mind spreads out and becomes quiet and clear, like the surface of a wide, clear lake. And then as if breathing is the center that supports all things, allow yourself to settle into the body breathing. Not to push anything away, but to kind of rest at the center. Breathing in the midst of all things. Allowing things to be as they are, except for being entangled or caught in what's happening. So let the breathing, the letting go of exhale, the opening of the inhale, be a movement of being of simplicity, allowing you to be simple in relationship to all things. If you find yourself drifting off in thought, and you notice that clearly, experiment with recognizing that that's what's happening in such a way that the recognition is peaceful, equanimous, untroubled by what is being recognized. So you don't berate yourself or feel discouraged. The thinking is just one more thing to know and to recognize. And to find a peaceful, clear way of recognition is to be mindful. And then begin again with your breathing. Always ready to begin again. in the last couple of minutes of this sitting. I'd like to first mention that one of the great tasks of Buddhist practice is to discover how to be peaceful in the middle of any circumstance we find ourselves. Not peaceful so we don't care, but peaceful so that we can care better. Peaceful so we can discover what is the appropriate response. And as you consider what you'll be doing today or tomorrow, where is it, and what activities would it be useful for you to plan ahead, to enter the situation looking for the peace, to see how you can be a peaceful being, peaceful person, in the middle of whatever is challenging.